शुक्लां ब्रह्म विचार सार परमा महात्यां जगद्व्यापिनी वीणा पुस्तक धारिणी अभयदां जाड्यांधकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वंदेतां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां नत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुण्यां करोम्यहं पाणिनीय प्रवेशाय लघु सिद्धांत कौमुदी। We are looking at Rukaranta Shabda, Vaya, Ukaranta Shabda, where Trijvat Krushtuhu Sutra made it partly Ukaranta based on some conditions. And then we saw Ukaranta, Dirha Ukaranta Shabda, with and without Samasa. And then now we are landing into Rukaranta. So, Osupi we saw last. Before that we saw this hu ityadi, and hu ukaranta is a little different than when it is in a samasa atichamum. When the ukaranta shabda, which is the uttarapada, that is nitya strilinga, then it gets a nadi samya, and in the samasa also it retains that nadi samya, therefore nudagama it may get, whereas in hu it may not get a nudagama, it won't get, so it will become Huvam, whereas Shashti Bahuvachana for Atichamu is Atichamunam. Before that we saw Urch as an example to Ratsasya, and Kroshtuhu is a counter example, where Sanyogantasya Lopa itself is sufficient, but Refat Uttarasya Sasyeva Lopa Bhavati said the Sutra Ratsasya, and thereby Urj is the right example for that. So we saw Urj also Prasangat in Ratsasya. So Sanyogantasya Lopa should have applied, but what happens in Urj, Repha Uttara is Jakara, not Sakara, therefore no Lopa. And Urj becomes, remains Urj, and then Chohoku Ityadi Sutras, here Chohoku Jhalam Jashvante, but Jhalam Jash is Parjanyavat, because Chohoku will make, Chohoku will make it, what, Jha, so Kakha Ga will be the Adesha. So if Ga is the Adesha here, it will become Urg, and then it lands on Jhalam Jashvante, that time Jashtam, Jash is what, third of the class, Chachaja, but this is already Ga, which is third of the class, and thereby Jashtam will be Parjanyavat. Even if you apply it, the result will be the same, and then I mentioned Kharicha, and I am revisiting this because I only mentioned Kharicha. So there are two forms, Urg or Urg, so I will just mention the other form also. Urg. This is by Chokku and then Jastvam, Jhalam Jashvante, and this is by Kharicha, which is optional. Kharicha Chara Adesha. So Chara Adesha is here the first of the class. So Gakara comes back to Kakara. Not comes back, but it comes to the Adesha is first of the class, not comes back. Here it was Jakara, but then Ja became Ga, and then Ga becomes Ka. So Urg or Urk, just like Virat or Virad, so the third of the class or first of the class are the options. So here Sutra is applicable, Choku, and then if we keep on visiting this, it will remain, if we remain fresh, somewhat fresh, Jhalam Jashvante, and then optionally Kharicha. Kharicha Adesha would be Char. And we saw this Vartika, which without the Vartika also we can do it by Vipratishede Param Karyam, and that can be interpreted as Vipratishede Aparam Karyam, based on where we need the Rupa Siddhi with Nut instead of Num. Okay, so I have gone back in summary. Osupi we saw, like A Ranekacha Sanyoga Purvasya, there only E Varna was mentioned by A He, here U Varna is mentioned by Osupi. What is the difference? Supi Eva, only when Supratya follows, then what? Then this is Supi, this is Supi, Osupi. Supi, when Supratya follows alone, this sutra has a pravritti. It will not apply in Tinganta or in Kridanta, like वर्ण अंत धातु विच इज इन अनेकाच संयुग पूर्व सिचुएशन यण आदेश विच अप्लाइज फॉर ई वर्ण एवरीवेयर अक्रॉस द बोर्ड हियर ओनली वेन सुप्रत्यय फॉलोज. सो व्हाट हैपेंस विद सुभो देर इज नो स्वभु स्वभु वेन स्वभु यू आर डिराइविंग स्वभु देर इज अ निषेध बाय न भू सुदीयो. सो देर फोर हियर यू सी हियर इट बिकम स्वभुव. सो ओ सुपी यण बट I don't think we did this example. Yanna sa sukhalopo. This is a counter example here. This one is a counter example here. Thereby he says evam sulvadaya. But swabhu there uvang will come back by na bhusudhiyo. So the example for this will be where yan is there. Here yan is not there. So we should go for this example here. Swabhu swabhu. Should go for this example here of khalapvo. So I'll just mention it. This is the example for it. And you see the difference between this. Here there is yan. Here there is no yan. Yan na bhavati. Next sutra Lagukara introduces is Varshavvashcha. Varshavvashcha kim bhavati. You can look at 6484. Are you able to see the Ashtadhyayi? Okay, good. So Varshavvashcha. O Supi, Supi, oh what? Yanadesha. Yanadesha is there, this yan which goes till 87. So Varshavvashcha yan. Because earlier what has happened with Nabhu Sudhi Oho, we saw the example here. This is an apvada. This is Nabhu Sudhi Oho. Bhu Sudhi Oho yan na bhavati. And this Varshabhu has Bhu. Therefore what will happen? Na Bhu Sudiyoho will negate the Yanadesha and this Varshabhu will have the applicability of Osupi, Yanadesha. But in Varshabhu, what will happen is that it will go to Er Anekacha, that section, and then because Varshabhu is having Bhu and he does not want this Na Bhu Sudiyoho to have Pravrutti in that, he makes a Puru Apvada here. So Varshabhu Vashcha Supi what? Yan Bhavati. Here it will negate Yan and then it will go to Uvangadesha. He does not want Uvangadesha, so therefore what does he say? See here Swabhuvo Uvangadesha, here Uvang has applied. He does not want Uvangadesha for Varshabhu, which seems like Swabhuhu. So Varshavvashcha, Varshabhuhu cha yasya asya Varshabhu iti shabdasya yan syad achi supi. So when achi supi what yan, this much we know from the vritti. If we need more, we have to go to the sutra patha, the section we just saw. Asya, so you see Varshabhu is just mentioned, Varshabhuscha. So how do you understand this? Varshabhu is in Prathama. So Varshabhu is in Prathama and Varshabhuscha what? He says Asya. How did he get this? Yes, Asya and Syad. So this we may question. So Varshasu Bhavatiti Varshabhuhu, that is the derivation of this, if we want to know the meaning anyway. Varshasu Bhavati, only in rains it is born. Varshasu Bhavatiti Varsha who. So this is in first case now. And oho supi. She is supi young, and here if you look at the supi goes till 85. So thereby here Varshabhu in 84 we have supi. Yan is also there, so that's why we added supi yan, and achi is coming from eko yan achi. So that is anyway there. So Varshabhuhu is prathama here. Yeah? Achi. Achi pratyaya pare. So is Varshabhu the adesha here? Yan is the adesha. So you have to understand this Varshabhu in sixth case. Let me see what other tika does. Varshabhvashch. Oh sorry, there is no split it wrongly. So Varshabhva. So I was thinking what went wrong. Sorry. So Varshabhva. Shashti ek vachana. I was just looking how has it interpreted. So Varshabhvashch is there, not Varshabhushch. Varshabhvashch. So I'm sorry, I made a mistake there. So this Shashti. That's why the confusion. I was questioning how it became Shashti. So Varshabhu, in the patha here that I have, he has mentioned Varshabhu. So in the as a laghuvritti is mentioned. So there is, other than the sutra, I have got Varshabhu. That's why I wrote as Varshabhu. But here, what has he written there? It is an example. So what he has done is here this Varshabhu. So this Varshabhu here. He is deriving this Varshabhu. I thought that this is the split there. I read this as a sutra and I misread it as Varshabhucha. So Varshabhuscha. So that's the mistake there. Anyway, so Varshabhuscha. I hope there is no confusion. No? Varshabhu is what? Shashti ekvachana of Varshabhu. So Varshabhu, Varshabhuha, Varshabhuha. So this, therefore Asya. Asya yan adesha bhavati when achi supi. When supratya, which is ajadi, so achi is ajadi pratyaya pare. Ajadi pratyaya pare, which is sup. Ajadi supi pratyaya pare, yan adesha bhavati kasya, Varshabhu iti shabdasya. And cha, because he wants this adesha, and this indicates that there is an apavada coming. Otherwise, this is siddha from this, like swabhu. Here we see not Sabhu, this Khalapu. So here you see Khalapu. Khalapu Shabda and Varshabhu sound similar here, Khalapu and Varshabhu. So for Khalapu, if it is available, not for why not for Varshabhu? This Osupi. So Osupi, by Osupi itself, Yanadesha is Siddha. Then why did he write this sutra again, Varshabhvashcha? So Chakarat, you know that something else is coming up as an apuada, and that apuada is, if you look at the sutra pata, you see na bhu sudhiyo is coming up. Therefore he wanted this, that bhu has an exception. It is unlike punj pavane dhatu, pu, bhu has a specific dhatu which has a specific sutra. Therefore asya yan syad ashi supi. So what happens? Varshabhau ityadi. So we will get Varshabhuhu, Varshabhau, not Varshabhuau, like what we saw here, Swabhuau. Swabhuau is an example for na bhu sudhiyo, yan na bhavati. And Varshabhuhu is an example here which does not take this na bhu sudhiyo. So it's a purva apvada. Then what happens to Drunbhuhu? So Drun is, so this is a difficult word. If you look at in your Gita Press book, in a footnote he has given, there are many meanings. Some interpret this as Surya, some as Sarpa. So it's a difficult word to know the meaning. Drun has Himsa meaning also. So how you get Surya? So there is a lot of Shastrartha there as to what should be the meaning. And usage wise there are many meanings. So I am not going into meanings. I just Prasangat I am mentioning. We are at least I am not so interested in meaning unless it makes sense. Because of the sutra, so why Varshabhu is not like Sabhu? That's how the language is. That's why the sutra. Not all bhu endings will have na bhu sudhiyo is common, general. But Varshabhuscha ओस सुपी यणादेश भवति एव व्हाई बिकॉज देयर इज अ डिफरेंस इन डेरिवेशन द वे इट इज pronunciation difference is there. So thereby sutras are created by sutrakara. We have seen that our approach is to understand the language, and the language is understood through vyakarana. You don't say that why it is like that, we don't know. So yeah, it is specific to Varshabhu. That's why the sutras is only Varshabhascha. So it is specific to this. What he is saying is that bhu is common. That's why, see, since we cannot see, since it is bhu. And now see, we know three words now. Let's say we know three words. Khalapu, one word. Okay, khalam punatiti khalapu. Then we know this word as this swayambhu or swabhu. So swabhu and khalapu, what is the difference? Both are ukaranta. So that is common. But the dhatu in pu is different than the dhatu khalapu. The dhatu is punj pavane. And in swabhu there is bhu dhatu, bhu sattayam. So that much difference we know. Now if we come across a word called varshabhu, we can say that it is like khalapu or it is like more closer to swabhu. Both are ukaranta, but looking at the dhatu content, the reason is khalapu declines differently than swabhu, then there is closeness to khalapu or closeness to swabhu. This is what we have to inquire into when we come across the word varshabhu. So varshabhu is obviously ukaranta wise both are same, but proximity wise it is more like swabhu. Then the thinking is that then it should decline like swabhu. However, it does not decline like swabhu, it declines like khalapu. And for it to decline like khalapu, meaning for it to take yanadesha instead of uvangadesha, he makes a purva apvada, varshabhascha. Is that clear? So whenever a particular word is mentioned, generally it is because some other apvada is coming. Sometimes the apvada is earlier, so that is purva apvada. Sometimes the apvada is later, which is a general apvada. But purva apvada is also there. So if we don't know, if we are studying ashtadhyayi krama also, if we do not know why he has created it, we don't see any other sutra, and it is siddha from the earlier sutra or in that section, then we should know that an apvada is coming up. So it is a purva apvada. Otherwise, what happens? Sometimes we see the sutra and then we say it has been said. So therefore, apvada follows later. Since it has been said earlier and this is not how it should decline, so there is an apvada, which is the general understanding of apvada. But purva apvada precedes. Therefore, we don't know why he is saying it. So sometimes it is niyamartha, as we saw earlier. If it is siddha, niyamartha. So niyama, it is, what is the niyama here? Niyamartha, because it is doing niyamana of the apvada sutra which is following. So na bhu siddhi yoho is an apvada sutra for the earlier yan which is prescribed, and that sutra na bhu siddhi yoho niyamanam is done by varshabhascha. So that is how it should be understood. Apvada to this, and then some niyamana, or some, either it is restricting or it is expanding the niyama. So there are various ways to understand the section where there is an apvada and a general and a restricted apvada. So what happens to drunbhuhu? So he brings in a vartika for that. Svartika. So drunbhu is siddha. For ekvachana we don't need anything. It's not ajadi. It's a supratyay, not ajadi. But in ajadi there are differences whether uvang should apply or whether we should have yan adesha. So vartika says drunkara punah purvasya bhuo yan vaktavya. So this is a apavada which varshabhu, varshabhascha gives a specific apvada for varshabhu shabda. But you see some other shabdas which take yan. So here varshabhu took yan. What about these shabdas drunkara punah purvasya? So those shabdas which have bhu, bhuaha. So bhuaha yana vaktavya, which kind of a bhu? So bhu should take yanadesha. Na bhu sudhiyo yan, but bhu should take yan in some cases, not only in varshabhu, if the bhu is preceded by drun, kara or punaha. So drunbhu, karabhu, punarbhu, these are the shabdas which should take yan, and thereby yan when अजादि अति अजादौ सुपि प्रत्यय परे यण भवति देयर बाय यू विल गेट ध्रुन भौ नॉट ध्रुन भूवौ सिमिलरली एवं करभू सॉरी करभू करभू विल बिकम व्हाट इन द्वितीय एंड प्रथमा एंड द्वितीय एक वचन औ और इन अजादि व्हेन अजादि प्रत्यय फॉलोस इन सुप प्रत्यय इट विल टेक यण आदेश सो इट विल बिकम करभौ So these, we will not see these words, but just to understand that even if you see na bhu sudhiyo, bhu is sitting right there, but still it takes yanadesha. Why? There may be some vartika, some exceptions, either via sutra or via some vartika, there is an apvada. Now he moves to, so evam karabhu, we will just mention here as to what he is saying is that, kara. Bhau, that's what you'll get. Now he moves on to Rukaranta proper. He's already covered some sutras in when he did the Kroshtu Shabda. He's not going to repeat them. We'll try to derive this because Rukaranta is very common for common Shabda. We did Akaranta, Ikaranta, Ukaranta. Let's do Rukaranta also so that we recall in this section whatever sutras we have done. So what happens here? So let's take this section. Su, au, jas, am, au, pyevda, am, au, shas. I'll write this. This time we'll do it a little differently. Am, au, shas, ta, bhyam, bhis, nye, bhyam, Yes. Nasibhyam yes. Ni. Oh, sorry, not Nusu. Tabhyam yes. Nibhyam. Tabhyam yes. Nibhyam yes. Nasibhyam yes. Then. Yes. Os am and then ni os sup. So these are our pratyas and we are deriving dhatru, 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 whatever rukaranta. So what happens with su? Rukaranta, sarvanamasthana. What is sarvanamasthana sutra? How do you identify sarvanamasthana? Anyone? Sudanapumsakasya. Okay. So we have the sutra now here. First, so recall all the sutras that we can. Dhatru is a pratipadika. How is dhatru a pratipadika? We'll do this exercise when we land on some important shabda once in a while. We have done it recently, but I just want to see. We'll do this in a Q&A kind of a session. Let's spend some time. Last time we discussed, we dropped one class also. I assumed people studied. So dhatru, how does it become a pratipadika? You can look up. There are so many sutras we have done. The books are with you. Let's spend this time of this class in exercises. Which sutra tells you that dhatru is a pratipadika? Yeah. Arthavat adhatur apratya pratipadika. What is the other sutra for pratipadika? Do you know any other sutra which gives a pratipadika sanya? There are two sutras. One is arthavat adhatur apratya pratipadika. But is that applicable here? Dha plus tru, you see. Possible, but is there a... Yeah, krutthadvita samasascha. So here, can you apply krutthadvita samasascha? Sakrutadita samasascha. Here this is a, you can see through which is a, can be seen as trijanta. Thereby we'll write both sutras here. So artha vad adhatu arthavat, it is arthavan. Adhatu, it is not adhatu. Dhatru is not adhatu. But dhatru has a meaning. Dhata, we say dhata vidhata, it has a meaning. Then adhatu apratya, is it a pratya? It is not a pratya. Therefore अर्थवद अधातुर अप्रत्ययः. व्हाट इज इट? प्रातिपदिकम्. प्रातिपदिकम. एंड देन नेक्स्ट सूत्र सेज व्हाट इट सेज कृत तद्धित समासाश्च. समासाश्च किम प्रातिपदिकम. सो एनी ऑफ दिस सूत्रास कैन बी यूज्ड. दिस कृत तद्धित इज बेटर बिकॉज दिस इज धातु इज कृदंत. देयरफॉर दैट विल बिकम प्रातिपदिक. नाउ व्हाट हाउ डिड यू गेट सु प्रत्यय. सो स्वौजस न्याप प्रातिपदिका स्वौजस अमौजस ताभ्याम भिस ऑल दैट. सो डिफिकल्ट टू राइट. ओके सौजस सौजस सुऔजस अम औट इत्यादि. एंड व्हाट इज दैट व्हेन वेयर आर दे अप्लाइड. न्याप प्रातिपदिकात दे आर अप्लाइड आफ्टर अ प्रातिपदिका. एंड व्हाट शुड बी अप्लाइड. न्याप प्रातिपदिकात प्रत्यय परश्च. कस्मात् पर न्या प्रातिपदिका. ज्ञान्ताद् आवन्ताद् प्रातिपदिकाश्च प्रत्यय परश्च भवति. इस सुम प्रत्यय यस इट इज अ प्रत्यय एंड देयर बाय दिस वी नो धातृ इज अ प्रातिपदिका बाय वन ऑफ दीस सूत्रस. एंड देन प्रातिपदिकात् प्रत्यय परश्च. हाउ डू यू नो सुऔजस इज अ ऑल दीज आर प्रत्ययस. In they come in the section pratyah parascha. So pratyah parascha is a huge section across third, fourth, and fifth chapters. So anything that is in the first case in third, fourth, and fifth chapters is a pratyah. No other definition is there. Samanadikaranam pratyah. Pratyah in third chapter it starts. Third chapter, fourth chapter, and fifth chapter. Whatever is in the first case is a pratyah. And where should it go? All this, any pratyaya should always go paraha. After what? Para later. After what? Jnanta, abanta or pratipadika. In this section at least. So pratyaya parascha is the sutra here. Then what will happen now? So we have added su to dhatru. What now? It is rudanta. रुदंत धातु. व्हाट शुड डू विथ रुदंत धातु नाउ. सो त्रिजंत वी ऑल्सो शुड नो त्रिजंत. व्हाट आर द सूत्रास वी डिड रिसेंटली. सो यू सी हियर रुदो मी सर्वनामस्थानयो रुदुशनस पुरुदंशो अनेहसांच. व्हाट हियर विद द अर्लियर सूत्र रुतो मी सर्वनामस्थानयो किम भवति. हियर देर इज एन उपदा दीर्घ. हियर व्हाट हैपन्स देर इज गुणा. सो रुतो मी सर्वनामस्थानयो गुणा भवति. लुक एट दिस सूत्र हियर. ऋतोंगी सर्वनाम अंगस्य गुणः भवति. देयर बाय गुण. व्हाट इज द गुण नाउ. गुण इज फॉर ऋ. अंगस्य गुणः भवति. डज एनीवन नो व्हाट इज अंग. अंगस्य गुणः भवति. हाउ डू यू नो व्हाट इज अंग. अंग डेफिनेशन इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू रिमेंबर. Sutra is difficult to remember, meaning is very simple. Yasmad pratyay vidhiyate. So, yasmad pratyay vidhiyate tadarit pratyangam. So, we need angasanya now. Yasmad pratyay vidhi tadadau pratyaye प्रत्यय अंगम. दिस इज द डेफिनेशन फॉर अंग. यस्मात् प्रत्यय विधि. यस्मात् प्रत्यय विधि विधिस्तदादौ प्रत्यय अंगम. सो टू व्हाट एवर द प्रत्यय इज एड. द प्रत्यय वॉज एडेड फॉर व्हाट. प्रातिपदिका. सो प्रातिपदिका आदि तदादि प्रातिपदिका आदि टिल प्रत्यय. टिल दिस प्रत्यय फॉलो दिस एंटायर थिंग स्टार्टिंग विद द प्रातिपदिका हियर बिकॉज इट इज ऑर्डेंट फॉर द प्रातिपदिका एंड एंडिंग विद दैट आफ्टर विच देर इज अ प्रत्यय. सो दिस एंटायर थिंग बिकम्स अंगा नाउ. सो दिस इज अंगा. धातृ plus soon. So what will happen here is anga, and we want the sutra ruta, ruto ni sarva namasthanayoho. What is sarva namasthana? Sudanapunsakasya. Sakasya. Sudanapunsakasya what? Sarva namasthanam. So we have anga sanya, we have sarvanamasthana sanya in pullinga here. Now rutas ni sarvanamasthana yoho, you can apply this. And what is rutaha? Rudanta. So rudanta tasmad, you have to apply the tadanta vidhi. What is the tadanta vidhi? So ni or sarvanamasthana. Ni saptami ekvachana. We are doing prathama ekvachana. So sarvanamasthana, the first five pratyas, including sambodhana. So what will happen here? Rudanta. So you need tadanta vidhi also here. Angasya. Angasya gunaha. Angasya guna. Otherwise you don't know what is the adesha, what should happen. Angasya guna. So rutaha angasya. Are in samanadikaranim. Anga is qualified by saying that it is rutha anga. So rudantasya anga, this visheshana rutaha will take tadanta vidhi. Yena vidhi tadantasya. So yena vidhi tadantasya, this sutra will give you tadanta vidhi, thereby it will become rudantasya angasya ni sarvanamasthanayoho gunaha adesha syat. Rutaha rudantasya angasya sthane. So the, and then should it reply the, replace the entire dhatru shabda? What will it replace? The guna. What should it replace? This guna is an adesha for what? For the anga. Will it replace the entire anga? We know it will not replace the entire anga. By which sutra? How will you know where should it apply? Does anyone remember the Paribhasha Sutra? How will you know what to replace? We know Ru takes the Guna. Anyone? Yes, no? Partially remember something? Does anyone remember this sutra? You've seen so many times. Alontyasya. At least tell me what the sutra says. What does Alontyasya say? Am I audible at all? I see no response even when I mentioned the sutra. Am I audible? Alontyasya. Okay. So alontyasya for Shashti last word, what does that mean, Amma? Shashti alontyasya, antyasya, whatever it is. So antyasya eva alaha bhavati. Antyasya alaha adesha bhavati generally. But and also nitya. Nitya, when nit pratyaya is there, then antyasya eva adesha bhavati. If the adesha is single letter or it has nit as an it letter, nyakara as an it letter, then only the last letter is replaced. If this sthani is multi-lettered, if this sthani is single letter, anyway only the single letter can be replaced. There we don't have this dvandva. When the adesha is multi-lettered or adesha is single letter and the sthani is multi-lettered, then we don't know what to replace. So if it is anekal, anekal adeshaha and anekal sthani, then replace entirely, except if the anekal adesha has nyakara as an it letter. So anekal shit, if it is shit or anekal, a single letter adesha with shakara as it,
that will replace entire word, or if there are multiple letters in the Adesha, it will replace the entire word, Sthani. If there is a single letter Adesha, it will apply to the Antya, Alontyasya, generally, if there is a multi letter Sthani. But if I have a single letter Adesha and it should replace the entire Sthani, then I will make it Shit. The Adesha will be made Shit. I will make it as in the Sutrakara has made it Shit, Shakara it. And if there is a multi letter Adesha, we say general rule is it will replace the entire Sthani. But I do not want the multi letter Adesha to replace the entire Sthani. I want the multi letter Adesha like Anang. Anang should not replace the entire Sthani, it should replace only the last letter, although it is a multi letter Adesha. Therefore, there he has made it Nyit. So, Nyakara is it. Excuse me, I'll just. So, there he has made it Nyit. So, Alontasya or Nitya will replace the last letter, and Anekal or Shit will replace the entire Sthani. Okay. So, Alontasya applies here, and thereby Ru is replaced by Guna. Now, what is Guna? We don't know what is Guna. Guna is the Adesha. How do you know what is Guna? Ru is replaced, we know. So, Ru has to be replaced with what now? So, Guna Sutra we need. What is the Guna Sutra? Definition of Guna, not the application of Guna. So, second Sutra in Ashtadhyayi, what is it? I expect more people to answer at least Guna. So, Guna, I hope everyone knows what is Guna. So, Adeng Gunaha. Adeng Gunaha, thereby Adeng Gunaha. And then we need the replacement as. Then, how do you know the replacement is Akara? So, Dhata, A is the replacement. For Ru, A is the replacement. But how do you know? How do you know that A is the Adesha for Ru? By what sutra? This may be a little tricky to recall, but we have to recall it. We have done this sutra, so you can go through the Laghu sequence itself and see which sutra will apply. You have Laghu Pata with you. Just flip through the pages and see if you know which sutra applies. I'll wait, because this is a good exercise for all of us. Otherwise, just knowing the meaning of the sutra without being able to apply it is useless. How do you identify what takes the Adesha? How do you identify the Sthani? Adesha for the Sthani. What is Ad Gunaha Ma? What does that sutra tell you? Ad Gunaha is just. Ad Gunaha does not tell you anything. It tells you after a there is a Guna. How is that applicable here? Completely unrelated sutra Ma. I am also looking through. Can you find any sutra here that we have done? Alontyasya we did just now. Alontyasya. What other sutra is there? Yatha Sankhyam Anudesha Samanam. Does it tell you something? Does it click something? But can it apply? Yatha Sankhyam Anudesha Samanam. Can it apply or not? If not, which sutra then?
स्थाने अंतरतम
गुड
आई एम वेटिंग फॉर दैट स्थाने अंतरतम इज द सूत्र सो टू सूत्रास टेल यू विच सूत्र विच विल बी द आदेश वेन देर आर मल्टीपल आदेश पॉसिबल देन एंड देर आर मल्टीपल स्थानीज इफ देर आर सेम नंबर ऑफ स्थानीज एंड आदेश देन वॉट सूत्र यू यूज यथासंख्यम अनुदेश समान रिस्पेक्टिवली इट विल अप्लाई लाइक इको यणची पॉसिबली इन इको यणची इज वन पॉसिबिलिटी इज दैट बट देन देर ऑल्सो वी से स्थाने अंतरतम बट स्थाने अंतरतमत्व शुड बी देर इफ देर विच आदेश शुड अप्लाई हियर देर इज ओनली वन स्थानी रू एंड आदेश आर मेनी देर आर थ्री आदेश अत इज अज एन अकार अत एंड एंग एंग इज वॉट ए एंड ओ सो अ ए एंड ओ एंड यू कंपेयर रू विच इज द आदेश नाउ देर स्थाने अंतरतम सूत्र दैट विल अप्लाई एंड देन यू विल गेट धात धात बट देर इज अ रेफा विच यू हैव सीन उरंडरपर सो देयरफॉर हियर यू विल गेट धातर प्लस सुन वाय धातर वन आदेश एस अवर सूत्र बाय विच वी गेट दिस आदेश इज वॉट ऋत नी सर्वनाम स्थान दिस ऋतोग्नि सर्वनाम स्थान यो हो सो हियर इट्स धात एंड उरण रपर देन उरण रपर सो वेन एवर एन अन्न आदेश अप्लाइज टू रू इट विल बी फॉलोड बाय र रेफा देयरफॉर यू विल गेट धातर रू इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय अ एंड इट विल बी फॉलोड बाय र सो वी हैव गॉट धातर प्लस सु व्हाट इज द कंटेंट ऑफ सु सकारा वी शुड हैव डन अर्लियर बट वी कैन डू इट हियर हाउ सर व्हाट इज द सूत्र बाय विच उकार गोस उपदेशे जनुनासिक इत एंड तस्य लोपः ओके देयर बाय सकारा नाउ व्हाट शुड हैपन टू दिस सकारा धातर स बिफोर दैट व्हाट द फॉर्म इज धाता द फॉर्म इज धाता हियर उपदा दीर्घ विच इज द सूत्र फॉर उपदा दीर्घ वी सॉ दिस वन डिफिकल्ट टू प्रोनाउंस रुदुशन सो अनेसांच अनंगसो सॉरी आफ्टर दिस अप्तृंतृच ऑल दिस सो व्हाट इज द उपदाय दीर्घ अप्त्रुन त्रुच स्वश्रु नप्त्रु नेष्ट्रु त्वष्ट्रु क्षत्रु होत्रु पोत्रु प्रशास्त्रुणाम हियर अनंगसो दिस इज नीडेड फॉर असंबुद्धि इन असंबुद्धि ऑल सर्वनामस्थान इन असंबुद्धि दिस विल अप्लाय अनंगसो बट धाता इज वॉट धातृ शब्द इज दिस इज अ जनरल रूल In general rule, you will get this adesha, angasya, asambuddho, anangsau, when su follows. We are doing su. Sustana. Sustana, generally anang is the adesha. But does aptrun take anang adesha? Or does it take this adesha? Here. So, this is the question. Dhata. Dhatar or? Okay, I think I... Sustana, I have forgotten. I think I may have gone a little. So, anang. Anang is the adesha. I applied the wrong sutra here. So, anang. So, I applied the sutra for the next one. Sorry. The austhana. Otherwise, you will not say dhatars. And then the form will be this sakara will undergo lopa. You will get dhataha. But the rupa is not dhataha. सो दिस नी सर्वनाम स्थाने इज द जनरल रूल ऋतो अंगस्य गुण बट वी हैव अ स्पेसिफिक सूत्र सो हियर यू सी ऋतो नी सर्वनाम स्थाने इति प्राप्ते इति प्राप्ते आई हैव अप्लाइड दिस सूत्र इति प्राप्ते इन क्रोश टू रुदंशस सो दिस रू दुशन सो रू इज देयर रुदंत सो ऋत रुद उशनस पुरुदंस अनेहसांच So, I applied the sutra blindly. Why is this here? Okay.
ओके आई अप्लाइड द सूत्र ब्लाइंडली हियर इन द सीक्वेंस ऋता गुणा भवति बट गुणा इज अप्लाई ओनली व्हेन हियर इति प्राप्ते जनरली इन सर्वनाम स्थाना दिस रूल इज अप्लाइज बट सुस्थाना हैज व्हाट इट इट हैज अ हैज एन अपवादा सो ऑल्दो सुस्थाना इज सर्वनाम स्थाना स्टिल देयर इज एन अपवादा व्हिच इज स्पेसिफिकली फॉर ऋत ऋजंत देयरफॉर गुणा विल नॉट अप्लाई अनंग आदेश विल अप्लाई सो इति प्राप्ते सॉरी सो दिस इज द रीजन वी डू इट वी डिराइव सो द मोर यू डिराइव द मोर क्लैरिटी विल बी देयर ऑफ द सीक्वेंस सो यू मे मेक सम मिस्टेक्स बट देन सी व्हाट हैपेंड हियर सो एनी ऑल दिस इज वैलिड एक्सेप्ट दैट नी सर्वनाम स्थान इति प्राप्ते सो वी आर Since we are looking at other sutras, I lost track of these specific sutras. So what will happen? This sutra will not apply here. But what will happen here? You will get the sutra. This is Anga. All that is fine. Gunantra for Adeng Guna. We will wait for that. This will apply here. Okay. सो अलौंत्यस्य अंगस्य ऋतः अंगस्य व्हाट इज द आदेश हियर ऋदु ऋत् ऋद् उशनस् उशनस् कुरु दंसो अनेहसांच नेहसांच च व्हाट इज द आदेश अनंगसौ नाउ वी नीड मोर परिभाषास Alontasya, but after that what? Nichya. So Alontasya will go in bracket here. Is anyone confused as to what is happening? Or are you getting it? So what is the mistake I made and what is the fix there? Is anyone confused? No answer means not confused. So in Sarvanamasthana, this sutra that we saw, which is what? Ruto. Ruto ni Sarvanamasthana, Sarvanamasthana yoho. What is that? Angasya gunaha. This is the sutra we applied. अंगस्य गुणः भवति एंड देन वी सॉ अदेङ् गुणः उरण्ड्रपरा ऑल दैट दैट इज ऑल स्टिल वैलिड बट व्हाट हैपेंस देयर इज अ पर्टिकुलर अपवादा फॉर सुस्थान दीज फर्स्ट फाइव स्थानास दीज फाइव स्थानास सुडनपुंसक दीज आर सर्वनाम स्थान सो ऑल दीज प्लेसेस देयर शुड बी गुण हाउएवर एक्सेप्ट फॉर सु व्हाई बिकॉज देयर इज अ स्पेसिफिक सूत्र विच सेज ऋत् ऋदंत एंड उशनस पुरुदंसः And then anehasa, these words will get in when su follows, there will be anangadesha, not guna. So here dhatar is wrong. What will be the adesha? Dhatar is will be right here, here, here and here. But here what is the adesha? Adesha being nit. It is what? Nitya alontyasya bhavati, antyasya. So dhatang, it will become dhat. Content is what? Anang. धातन अनंगसौ इज दिस क्लियर या देन उपदा दीर्घ धातान अदरवाइज यू नॉट गेट द फॉर्म यू विल गेट धाता द फॉर्म इज धाता नॉट विथ विसर्ग सो धातान धातान वाई धातान हियर व्हाट विल यू गेट So, Upadeshi Janunasikai. So, we'll just do this here. Dhatan. Or we'll shift it in the proper sequence. So, first Dhatru plus Sa. We'll remove the eighth letter first.
let's do in a sequence. So we remove this letter first. Upadeshi Janvinasi Kait, Tasya Lopa, then Dhatan, Anangadesha, An. This Akara Nakara, although it is multi-letter, since it is a Gnita Adesha, Nitcha Alontyasya Adesha Bhoti. Since the Adesha is Gnita Adesha, An is the control. Is replaced by An. You will get Dhatan. Dhatan plus Sa now, since we have already dropped the it letter. So Dhatan plus Sa. Now what? The next sutra that we saw, Upada Dhirga, Aptrun Trich. We are interested in Trich. Aptrun Trich. Trijanta. What happens here? Aptrun Trich. There is Adesha is what? There is Upadayaha Dhirgaha. Dhirgaha. This is the Adesha. This sutra will apply and you will get the form Dhatan. Upada Dhirga. What is Upada? So we need to know what is Upada as well. What is Upada? So we need Upada Sanya also. Which is what? Upada Sanya is Alontyat Puro Upada. Upada. Upada is that which is Antyat Alaha Purvaha. That which is after, before the Purva. Purva before the last letter. Last letter. This is Upada. And that will take Dhirgha Adesha. Anyway, we may also need Achascha as a Paribhasha. I'll just add there. Achascha. Whenever there is a Dhirgha Raswa, this Adesha will apply only to a vowel. So there is a sutra which is Achascha. Achascha will take this Dhirgha. And Dhirgha will be Akara Dhatan Sa. Then this what a Sakara is what? It is Ekal Pratyaha. Ekal Pratyaha, and we need that Sanya. What is the Sanya? Ekal Pratyaha becomes, gets what Sanya? Aprukta Sanya. Anyway, we will write the Sutra first and then. So, Aprukta Ekal Pratyaha. Why do you need this? In fact, I am doing it in reverse order. Ekal Pratyaha is called Aprukta. Aprukta Ekal Pratyaha. But we need this for Hal Nyab Jo Sutisi Sutisyapruktam Hal. Hal Lopaha means Lupyate. There is a Hal Lopaha. Sakara undergoes Lopaha. This Sakara, which is Aprukta, undergoes Lopa by this sutra after a Hal. There is a Halanta here. And Halni Abhyo, it is not Abanta. Hal, you see, Nakara is Halanta Anga now. And Sutisi Apruktam Hal Abhyo, Sutisi Apruktam Hal Lupyate, Lopa is there. And thereby, Aprukta, we need Aprukta Sanya by Ekal Pratyaya. This is an Ekal Pratyaya. It's a Pratyaya which has only single letter. So Ekal Pratyaya undergoes Lopa. And then the form that we will get is what? Sorry. Form that we will get is Dhatan. So Sakara undergoes Lopa, Sup Sakara. Now Dhatan, what kind of a Nakara is this? What is the sanya for this Dhatan plus Sa? The Su, when you add Su, what is the sanya that you get for the entire thing? What is Dhatan? It is a Pada. By which sutra? Which sutra gives you a Pada sanya? Suptingantam Padam. Do you know any other sutra that we have seen which gives Pada sanya? So when you recall some sanya, try to recall a related sutra as well. So it will stay. Suptingantam Padam. What else is called as Padam? What is that padantasyam?
Randomly quoting some words, amma padantasya kim?
Padantasya padasanyayul swadishu sarvanamastani. Yeah, swadishu swadishvasarvanamastani. Swadishvasarvanamastane padam. And yachibham bhasanya and pada. We have seen padasanya. So you will get suktingantam padam and swadishu asarvanamastane. Swadishvasarvanamastane padam. These are the two sanyas we have seen. One sanya with two sutras. So here suktingantam padam. And suktingantam padam, thereby dhatan is a pada. And this nakara, since ekadesha vikrutam ananyavat. So I also know eka, this is eka desha vikrutam. This is not a sutra, it is a saying in shastras, in vyakarana. Eka desha vikrutam ananyavat. So there is an eka desha vikruti, only ru has become this an. So ru has become an, but dhatu, you see the entire form, it is the same pratipadika which has changed a little bit. Eka desha has undergone, some part has undergone a change. Doesn't change the entire word. This word is as it is, pratipadika is as it is, it has just undergone some change. So eka desha vikrutam ananyavat, as though it is dhatru itself. So dhatru na. Na is still there, and this na is this padanta nakara as well as pratipadikanta nakara. Thereby what happens? Thereby nalopa prati padikantasya. Thereby nalopaha dhata. Thereby you get dhata. This is the rupa siddhi. So many sutras just to derive soon. What happens here now? We already done the some of the work. Rutongi sarvanamasthana yoho angasya gunaha adeng gunaha urandrapara. Thereby you will get dhatar. Dhatar. Sulit dhatar here. Dhatar plus O will become dhataro, but upada dirgha, you get upada dirgha here. How? By the sutra which we applied wrongly earlier. Which this rutongi sarvanamasthanu, in all sarvanamasthana except in su, because there is an apvada, particular apvada using su itself. So anangsau, we saw this sutra as anangsau. With this sutra here, Rudishan, this all is Rud, Ushanas, Rudishanas, Rudamso, Anyasancha, Anangsau. So Su is specific. All the Sarvanamasthana, in Su Sthana, there is a Apuada, Rudanta will take Anangadesha and not Guna. But otherwise, in all the other four Sthanas, it will take Anangadesha. Thereby, Urandrapara will apply, Guna it will take, it will not take Anangadesha, it will take Guna Adesha and then Dhatar. It will become Dhata and then Urandrapara will give you Dhatar. Dhatar plus Au. Au. And then we have the sutra for the same. Aptrantrich, all that. Upadaya Dirgha. You get Upada Dirgha. So the form is Dhatar. Dhatarau. Just Varna Milana. Dhatarau. Dhata, Dhatarau. What happens here? Same thing. Just content is what? Us. By which sutra? Jakara goes by which sutra? Tasya lopa, but it letter. How does it become it? Chutu. So chutu, then tasya lopa. Dhatru, then same other sutras, dhatarah, you will get by these, all these sutras will apply. Upadayah dhirgah, then dhataras, you will get dhataras by all this, and then what? So first you will get dhataras. So if you do stepwise, you will get dhataras and then धाता रस देन व्हाट हैपेंस विथ सकारा रुत्व विसर्ग व्हाट आर द सूत्रास फॉर रुत्व विसर्ग धाता रर हाउ धाता रर बाय विच सूत्र ससजुषो रुत्व दिस कॉल्ड एज रुत्व देन विसर्ग खरवसानीय विसर्जनीय धाता रह अम व्हाट हैपेंस विथ अम सर्वनाम स्थान सो ऑल दिस विल अप्लाई एंड यू विल गेट धातृ धातर प्लस अम धातर प्लस अम देन धातार धातार प्लस अम बाय उपदा दीर्घ बाय अप्रंतृच ऑल दैट धातारम एंड जन वर्णमेलनम सो हियर इट्स वी कैन डू धातारम रूपसिद्धि ऑफ द्वितीय एकवचन संबोधन वी हैव नॉट रिटन ओके संबोधन धातृ प्लस सु प्लस बट इन संबोधन देन धातृ प्लस औ इन संबोधन सूरोजस सो सो व्हाट विल हैपन हियर असंबुद्ध यू सीन समथिंग एल्स शुड हैपन हियर सो हियर यू सीन this anangsau so here anangsau what happens anangsau is only and so follows sutra that we saw here so rud ushanas kurudamsah anehasancha angasya asambuddhau sau what so asambuddhau but we are in sambuddhi now sambuddhi ekvachana संबोधन एक वचन इज कॉल्ड संबुद्धि असंबुद्ध सो वी आर नॉट इन असंबुद्धि एनी मोर द अर्लियर वन वी हैव टू राइट हियर असंबुद्ध ओनली सो बट व्हाट हियर द आदेश दैट वी सॉ अनंग सौ बट व्हाट सौ असंबुद्धौ असंबुद्धौ सौ बट दिस इज नॉट संबुद्धि हियर हियर इट इज नॉट संबुद्धि बट हियर इट इज संबुद्धि देयरफॉर Here that sutra will not apply. Then what will apply? If you do not apply anang, which was a specific apvada for sustana, but only in asambuddhi. So here in sambuddhi, anang adisha will not apply. Thereby you will still get guna, and then urandrapara. So you will get dhatar, dhatar plus sakara. What happens to dhatar plus sakara? Dhatar plus sakara, sakara. राक्षस्य एव लोपः भवति सो धातर राक्षस्य लोपः धातर सह सो राक्षस्य और कैन वी अप्लाई हल्नियाभ्यः सुतिस्य प्रुक्तम हल लुप्यते रेफा इज आल्सो हल So this is, I'll put a question mark here. Should we go to Ratsasya or Halniyabhya itself can do? I'll have to look up. Anyway, so one of these two sutras. And then, Dhataha. So this is He Dhatar. What will happen here? He Dhataha by Rutva Visarga. कृत्व विसर्ग कृत्व विसर्ग औ एज बिफोर ऑलरेडी डन सो धातारो धातारो जस्ट व्हाट हैपेंस हियर प्रथमयो पूर्व सवर्ण सूत्र इज देयर सो दैट इज अ स्पेसिफिक अपवाद सो बट हियर एवरीथिंग शुड हैपन बिफोर दैट कैन देयर बी प्रथम है पूर्व सवर्ण वॉट विल यू गेट देयर इन बोथ केसेस वी शुड हैव थॉट अबाउट अर्लियर अर्लियर केसेस ऑल्सो इन फर्स्ट केस प्रथमा एंड द्वितीय विभक्ति देयर इज अ प्रथम यो पूर्व सवर्ण बट दीज आर स्पेसिफिक अपवाद फॉर रुदंत सो रुदंत विल नॉट टेक दिस जसी च दीर्घा ऑल दीज आर देयर ऑल दो सूत्रास वी हैव स्टडीड दे शुड कम टू माइंड एंड देन आर देयर अपवाद हियर So we have to look at those apavadas then. So this is out. Out also we have done suojas am out shas. Su sambodhana au jas so he dhatara then am okay am so that is the confusion. This should have gone later. Sambodhana I did before. I need to do before sorry. Sorry for the confusion. I had forgotten Sambodhana. That's why, and I copy pasted it at a long place. So we have done. So these three are Sambodhana. What is the difference? Only he dhata, not dhata, but he dhata. Why? Because it is not asambuddhau sau. Asambuddhau sau, you will get anangadesha and thereby dhatan, and then dhatan, and then nalop of pratipatikasya dhata. But here. It will just get guna and urandrapara, you will become dhatar and then rutto visarga, you will get he dhata. The other two forms are same as in dvivachana and bahuvachana in sambodhana is same as dhataro dhataraha. We have seen guna, urandrapara, then upada dhirga by aptrishtran and then varnamilan, that's it. Out also we have seen dhataro. Shas what happens now? So that is the question. Shas what happens? Dhataru. Dhatru plus shas. So here what will happen? Dhatru, can it take guna? It is not sarvanamasthana anymore. So no guna here. As is the content. By which sutra? Shakara will go by what? Lashakvattadhiti. Tasilutaha. So dhatru plus as, not sarvanamasthana, thereby what will happen here is dhatru plus sudhatru, you get dhatrun. How do you get dhatrun? It is taking dirgha. So how will it get dirgha? By what sutra will you get dirgha here? Purva Savarana. So here, earlier there was a specific apvada for Sarvanamasthana. Prathamayo Purva Savarana. So Purva Savarana Dhirgha will be Dhatru. And then As. So Prathamayo Purva Savarana. This is Ekadesha. Prathamayo Purva Savarana Ekadesha. So you will get Dhatrus. How Dhatrus? Because Prathamayo Purva Savarana दीर्घ इज अनूर्थि एंड एकादेश एकः पूर्व परयोः एकः आदेशः एकः पूर्व परयोः देयर बाय बोथ रु एंड अ आर रिप्लेस्ड बाय पूर्व सवर्ण दीर्घ ऋकार दीर्घ इज ऋकार देयरफॉर यू गेट धातृस. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस टू दिस स, इट विल गेट नकार आदेश पूर्व सवर्ण कृता दीर्घात. सो दैट विच हैज टेकन पूर्व सवर्ण दीर्घ दैट विल टेक सकार सकारस्य न आदेश बाय तस्मात तस्मात शसोश ओनली फॉर शस शसो हो ससो तस्मात शसह ससो न पुंसी नकार अकार हियर इज उच्चारणार्थे. सो नकार इज द आदेश एंड हियर ऑल्सो वी कैन से अलोन्त्यस्य जस्ट टू बी श्योर थिंक बैक एंड रिकॉल दिस सूत्र धातृ धातृ प्लस टा व्हाट विल हैपन हियर. सो देर इज नो सी देर इज नो नदी संज्ञा बिकॉज इट इज नॉट द यू स्त्रियाख्यो नदी एंड शेषो घ्यसे की स हैज ऑल्सो अनुवृत्ति ऑफ यू. यू इज वॉट दी ई वर्ण एंड ऊ वर्ण ई वर्ण एंड ई एंड ऊ वॉट इज द संधि यण संधि. सो यू यू स्त्रियाख्यो नदी एंड सो नदी संज्ञा इज ओनली फॉर दीर्घ ईकार दीर्घ उकार अंत शब्द. दिस इज नीदर दीर्घ नॉर इकार उकार. सो हैड इट बीन इकार उकार अंत नॉट दीर्घ बट इकार उकार देन इट वुड हैव गॉट अ इट वुड हैव गॉट दी घी संज्ञा. सो इट इज नीदर घी नॉर नदी संज्ञा. अदरवाइज यू वुड हैव गॉट दिस अनंग. सो देर यू वुड हैव गॉट सम अदर आदेश. सो हियर वॉट विल हैपन नो नो पर्टिक्युलर सूत्र बट धातृ प्लस आ बाय सेम चुटु चुटु तस्य लोपः व्हाट रिमेन्स इज आ. सो यू अप्लाय विथ संधि नाउ प्लस संधि सूत्र अच संधि सूत्र व्हाट विल बी संधि. What is the sandhi here? Dhatru plus A. Ru and A, what is the sandhi? Anyone? What is the first sandhi in? What is the first sandhi sutra that we study? Aja in Achsandhi. This everyone should know. I hope everyone knows the sutra. Iko Yanichi. So, Iko Yanichi. So, we will get Refa Adesha. धात्रा सो इको यणचि एंड व्हाट अदर सूत्र विल यू यूज हियर. इकः नॉट एकः इकः इकः स्थाने यण आदेश भवति इउरु यवर. सो यू कैन से व्हाट इज दी सो वन ऑफ दी टू सूत्रस एक्चुअली बोथ कैन बी जस्टिफाइड but there is a particular reason that one sutra is used as to which should be the adesha. So it can be one of these two sutras as in sthane antartamah or the other sutra that we saw sthane antartamah is this is what applies here but there is also another sutra as yatha sankhyam anudesha samana. So I'll write both but sthane antartamah applies. Otherwise, some people say yatha sankhyam anudesha samanam. Anudesha samanam. Bhyam, just add them together. Dhatru bhyam. Dhatru vis, sakarutta visarga. Dhatru vihi. Nye. इको यणचि धात्रे धातृभ्याम सेम धातृभ्यस् ऋत्व विसर्गः धातृभ्यः न्यसि ऋत्वविसर्गः लशक्वत्तद्धिते देन ऋत्वविसर्गः एंड ऑफ कोर्स यण संधि हियर इज यण संधि अप्लाई हियर सो टिल हियर एवरीथिंग आई होप इज क्लियर सो दिस यू कैन डू ऑन योर ओन यण संधि हियर विल सी समथिंग एल्स हैपन्स हियर सो दिस मच यू कैन डू ऑन योर ओन फ्रॉम वॉट वी हैव स्टडीड Try to apply all sutras that you remember here also, and whatever sanya sutra, even if you just varna milna, you have to apply sanya sutra. Whatever you can remember, add those sutras here. Everywhere, do that as an exercise. This is simple what we have done, and add those and do this as homework for your own benefit. From here onwards, we will look at in the next part. वृत्तावसाने नटराजराजो ननादढक्कान्नो पञ्चवारम् उद्धरतु कामः सनकादिसिद्धान् एतद्विमर्शे शिवसूत्रजालम् एनी क्वेश्चन्स् No questions. So spend some time with this. See, I don't want to do a lot of sutras if they are not staying. So sometimes I'll take a break and we'll try to recall sutras where we know how to apply them. Otherwise, just learning sutras, we've seen. With these exercises itself, you know how much we remember. It's easier to understand during the class, but it has to stay. And it doesn't stay unless you use it. You have to keep on using it and then it stays. So we'll take up, because I think that most of you are not able to study. At least it doesn't show up in the class. When I ask a question, I expect more people to be able to answer it. It's okay, you make errors. But just staying mum is neither good for you nor for me. So if you spend more time in study, it is possible to recall. If not, then we'll try to apply it multiple times. Even if it is a Q&A session, I see, even if you don't answer, I do apply the sutra. So, it is only triggering your memory if you can recall something. And you have the help of books. There is sufficient time also. You can flip back pages and see. At least I hope you remember the section. When I am saying which sandhi, you know whether it is Asandhi and Hal Sandhi, at least you know the section. So, there may be 20-30 sutras. If you just flip through, you will get the sutras. So go through the sutras and try to recall. The more you apply, the more the memory will work when it is needed. Otherwise it doesn't. At least you should know what is happening there, what karya, even if you don't recall the sutra. It's good to recall the sutra. If you cannot recall the sutra, you should know yana sandhi. But the more you keep on saying yana sandhi, when should yana apply? If you don't remember ikasthane yana bhavati. Then, and if you can't remember that achi pare, then it is no use. Yana sandhi when? So, aj sandhi generally will not apply yana sandhi in hal sandhi. That much I assume that everyone will not make that mistake. But when, which sandhi should apply? Ikasthane, where it should apply? There, if you remember the sutra, it is easier to carry, easier to not make mistakes at least. So, that is the purpose of doing these exercises. I have absolutely no pleasure in trying to show you that memory is not working. It is true for me also. It is just to show you how much effort is needed and what kind of effort is needed. If you take any word and try to derive, apply all sorts of sutras, even if you think it is obvious to me, still you will know how obvious it should be, it isn't. Because we assume some things as I have understood, but application wise it is a little tricky. So that is the purpose of doing these exercises. And I want to show you that I may not do this all the time. So you have to do it on your own. Pick some word and try to derive at least what we have done. Even the same word that you have done, you can do. Preferably instead of hurry, take some other ikaranta and see whether you can derive. So that's the purpose of showing this. Okay, namaste.